days, a glimpse of stockings was looked down as something shocking. Now, heaven knows, anything goes. Good authors, too, who once knew better words, now only use four-letter words, writing prose. Anything goes. The world has gone mad today, and good's bad today, and black's white today, and day's night today, when most guys today that women prize today are just silly gigolos. So though I'm not a great romancer, I know that I'm bound to answer when you propose. Anything goes.
Good evening. Tonight's program has something for just about everyone. For starters, we'll be showing you some brief footage that we shot this past weekend out at Fire Island Pines. After that, if you've never been there, we'll be taking you to the Big Top Theater. Not for a look at a first-run film, but some scenes from a live on-stage soap opera entitled Mary Marvin, Mary Marvin, A Continuing Gay Saga. Later on in the program, Vito Russo, a name prominent in gay journalism, will be speaking with former Congresswoman and presently candidate for mayor of the city of New York, Bella Abzug. I would like to stop here and mention that the Emerald City, its producers and affiliates, are at the moment not endorsing any one candidate for the office of mayor of the city of New York. In closing this evening, we will once again be taking you to the Barbaran Theater Restaurant for a look at the music and comedy style of the group Gotham in a performance that we taped earlier in the spring. So if you're curious, please stay with us, and we'll be right back with just a peek at Fire Island after this. Thank you.
The sun, rising on a sea of glass. The ship, a poem of wind, canvas, and a gently rolling deck. Your companions, men who share your lifestyle and your longing for a simpler world, a world of adventure and romance, uninhibited fun. A dream? Maybe it was once, but late this summer, Firebird Travel can put you on a windjammer, a proud master of the seas, with people who know what kind of vacation you've been dreaming about since you read Treasure Island. But don't put off finding out about this fabulous Firebird Windjammer cruise too long. The ship only holds so many. Call Firebird Travel today at 686-0733 or drop by our office at 370 Lexington Avenue in New York City. It's your headquarters for gay adventures.
The Big Top Theater, located at 49th Street and Broadway, New York's finest in gay adult films. Not just a movie house, the Big Top features on Saturdays at 3 p.m., live on stage, The George Payne Show. Sundays at 3 p.m., The Mark Parrish Show. And now, playing 11 shows a week with a new episode every 2 weeks, the continuing gay saga, Mary Marvin, Mary Marvin. Check it out. We're open 24 hours a day, the Big Top Theater at 49th Street and Broadway. We doze but never close. We spent last weekend out at Fire Island Pines and stayed at the home of designer Jim Patterson. The following footage is only a small piece of the action.
Did you ever have to make up your mind to pick up on one and leave the other behind? It's not often easy, not often kind. Did you ever have to make up your mind? Did you ever have to finally decide and say yes to your mind?
up on one and leave the other behind. It's not often easy and not often kind. Did you ever have to make up your mind?
Boys lazed on the veranda, watched by hungry eyes, never doubting the attraction of the sunburned thighs.
They're not for you, little girl. They're much too beautiful for that. But take a look at Mr. X and see the way the boys react. React.
Now you watch him point his finger and the boy will come swaying gently for a purpose. Sucking on his thumb.
They're not for you, little girl. They're much too beautiful for that. But take a look at Mr. X and see the way the boys react. React.
Watch him smiling, so obedient, no, he's not his son. Can't you see from the way he's standing what will soon be done? Now they're leaving the veranda for a quiet place. There's no reason to be uptight. It's quite commonplace.
They're not for you, little girl.
Good evening, I'm Richard Freed.
And I'm Marianne Kalega. Once again, here's Gays Week's preview of upcoming events. Be sure to jot down these dates and phone numbers. There's surely something for everyone. Tonight, Monday, August 8th, if softball is your game, come watch all the Queens women playing in Casino Park in Flushing, Queens. From all the reports that I've gotten, the game is really dynamite. For further information, call 359-9204.
This Tuesday, August 9th, a straight discussion on gay people will be the topic at the Westside Discussion Group. A panel of reasonably straight members will deal with the subject openly, honestly, and realistically. That's at the West Side Center, 37 9th Avenue, at 8 p.m. Admission is $2. For additional information, phone 675-0143.
Also, on Tuesday, the 9th, Integrity, the Episcopal Gay Society, will celebrate the Eucharist of Pentecost 10. Reverend Dale Cranston, celebrant. However, the fun starts after the Mass during happy hour, which promises to hold some pretty vital small group discussions. It's in the Village at St. Luke's in the Fields Church, Hudson at Grove Street. The time, 7:30 p.m.
And it's the weekend again, Saturday, August 13th. The Organization for Gay Awareness is planning a Westward outing featuring wine tasting, a quaint dinner in Lambertville, New Jersey, and all the action you can muster in New Hope, PA. Carpools will be organized from 40 Southman Avenue, East Orange, New Jersey. Call 201-672-4654 for information.
Later that night, get up and boogie. At 9 p.m., the Gay and Lesbian Community Services of New York, also known as the Mattachine Society, will co-sponsor with the West Side Discussion Group the most exciting benefit dance to come to the city in years. Raffles will be sold at, and the grand prize being a trip to San Juan. Raffle tickets are available at the Pleasure Chest, Club Bats, Women's Coffee House, and at Danny's. The $2 donation will be divided among both groups along with the Gay Community Chest. That's Saturday the 13th at 9. The place is the West Side Center, located at 37 9th Avenue.
And if all that isn't enough to keep you busy, we have some regularly scheduled events that take place every Saturday. First, at 1 p.m., Gay Youth holds their weekly meeting at 348 West 14th Street. Does that mean one has to be under 21, under 30, or under 7? Find out and let us know. At 2:30 p.m., a women's wrap takes place for lesbians and bisexuals. That's natural enough. It's at Identity House, 544 6th Avenue. Call 243-8181 for information. And why not finish Saturday off with a hike? Hiking Dykes sponsor them every week. Call Jay Silfka at 569-1888 for details.
Sunday brings the sun and the surf, and hopefully it will be a nice enough day for a successful beach outing at Reese Park for all Dykes and their tykes. Call Steph at 789-5206 for details and carpool arrangements. Bring a friend, your lunch, and a frisbee. Sunday, August 14th at 11 a.m.
Monday must be our day of rest, but watch it. Tuesday, August 16th. Circumcision, its pros and cons, is the subject of this week's talk at the West Side Discussion Group. Dr. Ken Unger will field all questions. He may find the group just too hot to handle. Check it out. That's the West Side Center, 37 9th Avenue. 8 p.m., there's a $2 admission charge. Call 675-0143 for information.
It's Tuesday night for the movies with the Organization for Gay Awareness. This Tuesday, the 16th, they're holding movie night, replete with popcorn. They'll feature a classic, My Bets on a Bette Davis or Joan Crawford number. It will be shown at St. George's Church, 550 Ridgewood Road in Maplewood, New Jersey. The time is 8:30 p.m. Call area code 201-672-4654 for directions and information.
These are just some of the events taking place in the Big A this week. For additional information and lots more to do, why not pick up a copy of Gay's Week at your local newsstand? I'm Richard Fried.
And I'm Marianne Kalega. Good night.
Good night.
Wondering what this world's about. Has the answer.
Chaps, 3rd Avenue between 87th and 88th.
From the Big Top Theater, the continuing Gay Saga, Mary Marvin, Mary Marvin. We find our hero, the 17-year-old innocent Marvin Breakwater, lying helplessly in a hospital bed, every bone in his body broken.
This must be the room.
Don't wait for me, Michelle. Wait for me.
I'm sorry, but no one's allowed in here.
Oh, that's all right, honey. We're friends. No, no friends, nobody is allowed in here.
Apparently you don't understand. See, I'm Lavoie Andrews, it's landlady, don't worry.
But you can't, you can't! What's your problem? It's a rule, there are no visitors allowed here.
Well, rules are made to be broken. And if you don't want your neck broken, I suggest you be a nice orderly and leave us alone, all right?
But I'm trying to tell you, I'll get into trouble if I let you stay in here.
Honey, you're not gonna get into trouble with nobody. I'm Lavoie Andrews, Hattie, Maxine, Rum and Coca-Cola, Boogie Woogie, remember me? I carry a lot of weight, honey. I carry a lot of weight in hospitals. I have people up at the top, if you know what I mean. You know, up at the top, right? And you're not gonna get in trouble. If I wanna visit, I'll visit. I pay your salary with my taxes.
But I don't get paid, I'm a volunteer.
Well then, why don't you go volunteer for the candy stripers? Can't you see this is our moment of grief? We're in grief. Leave us alone. Scram. Oh, Marvin.
Marvin.
Hear me, honey.
Marvin.
It's me, Lavoie, honey. Oh, Lavoie. No. And Juan and Michael
yes,
are here.
Yes, here.
Marvin, can you hear me? Honey, don't worry. You're in good hands, honey. And they...
He can talk in?
No, probably not. I don't know. Oh. Answer me, Marvin.
No, wait. No, wait.
No, Marvin.
Oh,
Marvin, can you hear me, honey? Marvin, can you hear me, doll? I said go play with your stethoscope, all right? Marvin, honey, it's loving me. Go get somebody an enema, all right? Go away. Apparently, you didn't get me.
What are you doing in here? There are no visitors allowed.
Oh, that's all right, honey. We're not visiting. We're friends, okay? See, I'm Lavoie Andrews, Patty and Maxine, and we're just visiting.
I wouldn't care if you're the Boswell sisters. He's not allowed to have visitors, only family and medical staff. So if you're visiting, you'll just have to wait.
That's all right. Only a minute or two is all we need. See, I'm his landlady, right? And we're here, and while he's in the hospital, we're painting his room back home. We just want to see what color he wants his room.
Well, you better paint it by numbers. He's going to be here a long time. Get your pimpy little buttocks out of here. If you're not family or medical staff, you got no business being here. Understand? No!
only family. Family? Family. Family, I...
Family!
Oh, shit. Oh. Lavoie! This is so stupid, I feel like an asshole.
Oh, no. Oh.
Well, if it's any consolation, Michael, you look like an asshole.
This plan's never gonna work. They're gonna find out who we are, and they're gonna throw us out again.
If you just calm down and act normal, just pretend you're little kids, all right?
Oh, that feels so ridiculous.
Oh, I feel ridiculous. Más ridiculous, you know, ridiculous, yes, I feel ridiculous.
Cram it, baby snooks. Now look, just act normal. Whatever I say or do, you go along with, okay?
Okay.
All right.
Come on.
Hey, is this the room with little Marvin Breakwater in it?
Huh? Yeah, but no, there are no visitors allowed.
Oh, that's all right. You see, we're his family. And I'm his long-lost grandmother. Yes. Beatrice Beulah Bertha Breakwater. And this is baby boy Bobby Breakwater. And this is, and this is baby Becky Barbie June Breakwater.
No!
And we're from Cockapoo, Iowa. And we're his only family. All right, so if you don't mind, we'll visit with Marvin.
There he is! Marvin!
Well, they sure don't look like him. And this one doesn't even sound like him.
That's all right. She's got a speech impediment. She's demented for her age. So you just be a nice little orderly and fuck off. All right. Marvin. Marvin, it's me, LaVoy. And they wanted Michael here, and they're not gonna chase us out, because if they do, it'll be over your dead body. Now, Marvin, listen.
He's all bandaged up. How come he won't talk to us?
I don't know, but I'm gonna tell him what happened anyway. Marvin, last night.
He can hear, maybe. He can hear you, no?
No, probably not, but if he can, I'm gonna tell him anyway. Marvin, last night at the seance, Percy Rockefeller told you to go run out in the street. And you did. And a little old lady gang of moped drivers struck you down. Oh, Marvin, in the prime of your youth, too. And they left you to die, bleeding on the sidewalk. Oh, in front of the Thumblet Dick Chinese restaurant. See, we just came to show Marvin some pictures of home. If I can... Some pictures of home. Someplace in here.
Oh, get one.
What's going on here?
All right.
You're all imposters. You're that crazy bunch I threw out of here 10 minutes ago. Get the hell out of my ward. And don't you let me get you back in. Posing as family. Here's only medical staff. Understand? Medical staff! Now out!
Shut up!
Miss Brown! Nurse Brown!
Something to gag him.
Okay. A gag?
A gag.
Well, there should be a napkin or a, you know.
Anything?
Nurse Brown!
Oh, shut up.
Nurse Brown! Miss Brown!
All right, now.
Oh, what is that?
Came from.
Where should I put them?
In the closet, over there. Looks like a beached whale. Orca. Get in there. Said there was a will, and Marvin must have it wrapped up in these bandages. We gotta find that will. Michael, you check the
will.
I'll check
the will.
Okay.
The will.
Okay. Oh, LaVoy, look what I find. Look, they give Marvin drugs.
Drugs?
Yes.
Did somebody say drugs?
Yes, me, I did. You know, the doctor gives Marvin drugs, and my husband was a junkie.
What is that? Anesthetic?
Yes.
It's something that makes you numb all over.
Numb all over?
Yeah, and I think somebody gave you a local. You're numb in the head.
Oh, really? Oh, they're not giving Marvin drugs? Oh, really? Oh, my husband's not junkie?
No, he's not a junkie. Now, please put that away before you hurt
yourself. What am I doing with this? What am I...
Just stick it someplace, all right?
All right.
I shouldn't have said that, no. Just give it to me.
No, I keep you.
I said give it to me.
Okay, I keep you.
Oh, just what I've always wanted, a limp wrist.
Hey, you hear me? Stop shaking your head and answer me. I said answer me, you dumbo!
Thank you.
Like to get out of the city once in a while? Are you tired of the same old places, the same old faces? Wouldn't you like a place that wasn't too far away, but just far enough? A place where movies are shown twice a week, where you can play pool or pinball with friends or just friendly strangers. If this sounds like your kind of place, make headway for Billy the Kid in Jackson Heights, Queens. Take the BMT to 76th Street. We're located directly under the L at 7607 Roosevelt Avenue in Jackson Heights. Billy the Kid, come on. Also, take the EF or 7 train to 74th Street, Jackson Heights.
Good evening. I'm Vito Russo, and I'm sitting here with Bella Abzug, former congresswoman who is running for mayor of New York City. Hello, Bella.
Hi, Vito. How are you?
I'm pretty good. How are you?
Great.
There are a couple of questions I would like to ask you, which are specific questions about how you feel that the mayor of New York City can serve the gay community. But I'd like to start off by talking a little bit about the attitudes in New York towards gay people and your perceptions of what they are. Recently, we saw the defeat of a gay rights bill, the repeal of a gay rights bill in Dade County. And I'd like to know what you think would happen if such a vote were called in New York City, how it would shape up.
Well, the real problem is that we have to conduct a much more intensive educational campaign before we're in the moment of a vote.
Yeah.
It's important. I think that there is a lot of misunderstanding about gay rights. And my approach has been, and I discuss it all the time in my mayoralty campaign, in all of the communities, is that America is very proud of the fact that they